Now, the whole point of a live sound system is to take a sound, turn it into a signal, process that signal, then boost it way up so speakers can turn it back into sound waves, just way louder. Then a large audience can hear the original sound. Now, of course, this is way oversimplified and there are a ton of parts in that system. But the way we turn sound into signal and signal into sound is with a transducer. Technically, a transducer is something that takes one form of energy and turns it into another form of energy. For us, it's acoustic sound into electrical signal, or the other way around. But for the first part of the process, the sound into signal, we use a tool called a microphone. And, you know, I love microphones. I'm kind of a nerd about them, and it's so cool how some of them have such different sounds. And even though it's not as varied as the studio, there are a ton of different kinds you can use for live shows. But honestly, there is one brand you're going to see way more than other brands, and that's Shure. They really had a hit with their SM57 and SM58 microphones dating way back to the 60s. And if you've been on stage much, I'm sure you've seen them. And even though some people prefer Audix or Sennheiser or whatever, you're more likely to see Shure microphones on stage pretty much anywhere in the world. This doesn't change when you get to huge concerts. We still use SM58s for arena shows. But the other transducers we have are speakers. And this is way more complicated than choosing a mic. The physics of sound alone make large speaker systems really tricky. But in the same way that a microphone turns the sound into signal, a speaker turns the signal back into sound. And some speakers we use for big live shows can sound amazing. It's just really expensive for manufacturers to make high quality systems that can cover thousands of people at high volume. And so the really high quality, high powered audio systems that you see at big concerts can end up being multi-million dollar setups. Obviously, not every venue can afford that kind of expense. So the good thing for us is that the quality of inexpensive speakers has gotten so much better over even just the past 10 years. And this means that nowadays we're able to have good sound almost anywhere.